Nowadays, a business can be conducted anywhere in the world. Larger corporations often institute an international business model in which they're locating their company through multiple countries around the world. Now, there are many reasons why a business would want to look into an international business model, and it really revolves around money. There are numerous reasons why you're going to cut costs by locating yourself in many different regions of the world. First off is shipping. You don't want to have to ship product all throughout the world and have to pay high tariffs or other taxes when you're importing goods. Another reason is labor. Labor is often cheaper in a certain country, and again, if the product is going to be distributed to that country, it makes more sense to manufacture it there. Lastly, again, are essentially taxes. It's not uncommon for a business wanting to avoid some income taxes they typically would have to pay if they manufactured a product in the United States. Now, the government often will work with larger corporations to try to keep them all of their production processes in the United States so that those goods are then exported to other countries and then again taxed. One problem with the United States nowadays is more and more products are actually produced outside the country and then brought into it, and that's not creating the jobs that the country needs. Now, essentially, trade is really regulated by the World Trade Organization, among others. Again, they're going to oversee to make sure that trade is as balanced as possible, and governments or essentially businesses aren't taking advantage of governments and doing unethical practices to avoid paying a lot of taxes. There are numerous businesses that are often considered corrupt because they're not paying their fair share of income taxes, among others. Now, when it comes to international business models, there are many different you can actually pursue. For example, McDonald's. McDonald's has locations all over the world, and in different regions, they have different types of McDonald's. For example, let's look at China. China has a couple different types of McDonald's. They have one type of McDonald's that is just like what we have here in America, in which it is essentially Western food. You have cheeseburgers and everything else that is typically you would get at a McDonald's in the US. Then you actually have McDonald's that are specific to the food that would appeal to the average Chinese individual. So again, they customize some of the McDonald's to the local area, where others are the traditional and allow somebody to experience the Western culture. So again, you have many different types of international business models, and it's really gonna depend on the type of business. Coke is another really well-known international business where essentially they have manufacturing plants in more countries than they don't. This is because a can of Coke or a bottle of Coke is not that expensive of a product, and you want to make the distribution as close to the consumer as possible. And again, by manufacturing it in many different countries, it really allows them to be as efficient as possible. If you have any questions on how international business can help your business, please do not hesitate contacting us. Thank you.